the knowledge of the world. We want to store it for future generations. In books, with the codes of the different languages. In digital codes on hard drives or on other electronic media. But all of this storage has one crucial weakness. Books fall apart, they crumble away or burn, and newer things like memory sticks either get lost or just stop working at some point. If you store data, it's a familiar problem. 10-year-old CDs may not function anymore. Digital storage media just aren't designed to preserve data long-term. There's currently no technology that stores data reliably over a very long period of time. That is what prompted the two chemists Wendelin Stark and Robert Grass to search for a storage medium that would enable data to be read even thousands of years from now. And they've actually found that data storage medium in nature. It's existed for millions of years. All the information about life on Earth is contained inside it. It's the oldest code in the world, DNA. When we store information digitally, we use zeros and ones. That's what we have on our computers or disks. But we can also use nature's building blocks for this. These are A, C, T, and G, the four bases of the genome. So we now simply translate the sequence of zeros and ones into A, C, T, G language. So the researchers take nature and combine it with technology. For example, every character in a book can be translated into digital code. And that, in turn, into a DNA code. A sequence of DNA letters is created. This construction plan then enables artificial DNA to be produced. And the information inside an entire book can then become DNA. But protecting it effectively is a challenge. The problem with all of the previous approaches was that the information wasn't stable enough if simply translated into DNA. The stability doesn't only depend on the DNA itself, but also on sealing the DNA inside another material. Nature has provided a role model for this problem too. The two scientists took their inspiration from fossils. When sealed away inside bone, DNA can remain stable for hundreds of thousands of years without damage to any of the information inside it. So they had to find a material that seals synthetic DNA just as effectively and makes it stable. Robert Grass and Wendelin Stark spent months searching for this substance. Finally, they try using tiny spheres of non-porous silicon dioxide, that is, glass particles. These are only 1/10,000th of a millimeter in size, and so they're only visible under an electron microscope. The researchers seal the DNA inside these tiny spheres. There's enough DNA in each one to store two pages of a book. Then the researchers do the stress test. They store the glass spheres for 1 week at a temperature of almost 70 degrees Celsius, the equivalent of 2,000 years of storage in Central Europe. Will the DNA and the information it contains remain stable? The scientists can only establish this by freeing the DNA from its glass armor again without damage. The problem is that we can't read the DNA when it's inside the glass particles, so we have to remove it. With glass, we chose the most stable material in existence. But there are fluoride ions, and they react with glass, so we can selectively dissolve the glass without destroying the DNA. Using these biotechnological methods, the researchers succeed in retrieving the valuable data from the tiny glass beads. After 3 years of intensive research, it's now clear. The DNA data stored inside the synthetic glass fossils is undamaged. The DNA code can be read in its entirety again and translated back into the original information. The researchers even use this technique to preserve a music album for eternity. But it's not only data that can be stored using this method. Grass, Stark and two of their colleagues found the spin-off company Helixer AG in order to market their invention for stored DNA sealed inside glass. These invisible DNA markers are a sort of identity card that cannot be forged. They are non-hazardous, so they can be transferred to any product. For instance, to textiles, tropical fruit, gold, or even diamonds. In this way, the product's origin can be traced from production, through processing, to the end consumer. Saving data in DNA is currently still expensive, and only possible in the laboratory. But Robert Grass and Wendelin Stark believe that the technology will prevail, and soon become more widespread. With these technologies, data can be stored for very long periods, probably millions of years, far longer than with any digital media today. And DNA is the basic component of our own biological information, so we'll always be able to read it. And as with other technical developments, we can assume the devices will also be a huge amount smaller, more manageable, cheaper, and more widespread. 400,000 terabytes of data, the equivalent of all the films currently available on YouTube, can be stored in just a tiny amount of DNA. With this method, today's technology will be revolutionized.